Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is going to be a cool little video. In this video, I'm going to show you some daily guitar stretches and warm-ups. Now this is a bigger deal than you think. I never used to stretch my hands and warm up before I started playing guitar, and my playing really suffered. Have you ever been in a situation either playing guitar in the house, at a jam session, or even before a gig where it takes you a while to get into it? If you warm up your hands, both of them, before you start playing, you won't get any of that. You'll be ready to go straight out of the gates, and these little warm-ups and stretches literally take 5 minutes, and you can do them either plugged in or just sat with a guitar on your lap watching Coronation Street. It's all about getting blood to the end of those fingertips. Even when you're making a cup of coffee in the morning getting ready to play guitar, have a guitar on you and just sit and have a little fiddle. I will quickly just say before we get into it, some of these warm-ups are a bit hard on the old digits. In some cases, it might be the fact that you do these warm-ups and you're a bit too tired to even play guitar. But that's kind of what you want. Hear me out, okay? Like Arnold Schwarzenegger, he's a big guy and he lifted things until he couldn't lift anymore. And then he rested, and then when he went to go lift more things, he could lift more than he originally could. That kind of makes sense. It's the same with your fingers. Once you get the strain and give it all you've got, rest a little while, and when you come back, the muscles in your fingers will be already stretched in enough, ready to be stretched again. Okay, let's get into the stretches and the warm-ups. Stretching wise, this is literally the thing I do when I'm making a coffee in the morning. It's all about getting the blood to your fingers. So simply just grab your thumb. You'll do this to both hands as well, but for the sake of this video, I'll just do it to the left. And just simply massage your palm and massage all the way up your fingers. While the kettle's boiling in the morning, or while you're, I don't know, sat on the toilet, give your hands a little bit of a massage, your left and your right hand. Your right hand is just as important as your left hand. Go up the arm as well, just make sure you're all nimbled up as if you're going into battle, because you kind of are with these beasts, aren't you? So, blood's pumping, let's do some stretches. Simple, lock the elbow out, grab your little fingers, little pull back, as much as you can. Don't go too much, otherwise you will snap your fingers off. Pull them back. Little stretch, either arm with the elbow locked out. And do the same thing with your hands down the way. When you pull it back though, wiggle your other fingers. So pull down your middle finger, wiggle the rest of them, and the other ones as well, just to get all the blood going to your fingers. Repeat on your other hands. It's weird doing this kind of video. Normally I'm just showing you guys how cool amps sound, but giving you all the little secrets. So those are the stretches and the little massages you should do to your hands. Now let's get into the playing. Left hand and right hand. There's a few little warm-ups I've stolen pretty much off some of my favorite guitar players over the years, and I've used them myself, and it really does make a difference. And we'll be focusing more on the left hand to begin with, then a few right hand exercises at the end. However, you do need your right hand to simply pick these first exercises. And the first one I took from Jim Root from Slipknot and Stone Sour, and it's a little chromatic thing. And all you're doing is starting at the first fret with your first finger, and chromatically going up each fret. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then go up a string and up a fret. Also with your right hand, try and alternate the picking, so you're going up, down, up, down, up, down. And repeat this, up a string and up a fret. Until you can't go anymore. Then you start descending, but still going up one fret. So that's the first little one. Just literally sit there in the morning, guitar on your lap. Now a bit harder is to descend that. So start up here, so your pinky will be on the 14th fret of the low E string, and descend, going down a fret and up a string. Okay? Okay. Yeah, You might have noticed a little cut in there, and that's because I messed up a few times. Nothing wrong with that, but what I will say is every time you mess up, you have to go back to the start. Kind of be hard on yourself a bit until you get it right, no matter what speed you go. This next warm-up is actually a warm-up from Dimebag Darrell from Pantera and Damage Plan, one of my favorite guitar players, and it certainly gets the blood pumping. Again, you haven't got to go super fast off the bat, just until your fingers start to feel a bit achy, and this one definitely makes your fingers feel a bit achy. So we're going to start in the same place as that first one, down at the first fret. And simply do hammer-ons and pull-offs with your... So this is one finger, two finger, three finger, four finger, one and two. And just go up the strings like that, okay? I'm not going to do the whole thing, but see how far you can get up the fretboard. Once you get to the higher end, move up a fret, and again on the descend, move up a fret again. This is a great warm-up to judge your ability and watch your improvement, because the first time you do it, before your fingers get too tired, is maybe the fifth fret, the next time, eighth fret, and so on and so forth until you're shredding away like Dimebag Darrell. So once your middle finger, your finger two, is nice and tired, move on to finger three. So first fret, and the third fret now. And move up the neck, and again, judge your process. When your ring finger gets tired, time for the pinky, the hardest one of all, on the fourth fret. And so on and so forth, until your hands are literally gonna fall off. Then take a little break, and then play some guitar. Next up, we have a one that I struggle with personally, but it's so much fun to play, and when you watch it done correctly, it's amazing. It's one I was shown by my good friend, Mr. McRocklin, Thomas McRocklin, and boy, it's a finger twister. So again, if you were to number your fingers, one, two, three, four, this is this one, and it's really funky. One, four, these correspond with the frets now too, okay? One, four, three, four. But then go two, four, three, four. So the first one again. One, four, three, four, two, four, three, four. It's damn hard on the fingers, but when he does it, it sounds fantastic, and it really gets the blood pumping to your fingers, and it helps you articulate yourself. Three more to go, then we'll move on to the right hand. The next two involve the minor pentatonic scale. If you don't know what that is, it's this. I'm using this position right here from the fifth fret. 5-8 on the low string. And then 5-7 on the A, D, and G. And on the B and the E, you repeat the low E string. So go 5-8. And then go down the way. But that is not the little warm-up. The warm-up I want to show you is using different fingers. So play the entire scale with your first finger to begin with. Something like that anyways. And then move on to your first and your second finger. To get that stretch in. Okay, it's hard to do. One finger to begin with, and then your first and your second finger. The entire scale, up and down. Then 1-3. And finally 1-4. Ideally, you want to play this to a metronome. Start off slow and get it clean, much cleaner than what you've just heard it. But start with the metronome and then build the speed up, okay? And you can do this anywhere. Now we're going to stay in the minor pentatonic box for the next one, but kind of fall back on ourselves every now and then. This is delving into actual guitar solos, like Bonamassa loves this technique, Zach Wild and Eric Johnson, and it's essentially playing the pentatonic scale but kind of falling back on yourself and then going forward and then back again, like this. So instead of just following through with the scale, you want to dip back on yourself. And this is just a warm-up. No one's actually going to be listening to you while you do this, so you can be as random as you want. Just keep it clean and get loosey-goosey with it, okay? And lastly, for the left hand anyways, and kind of this one involves your eyesight and your feel, even your shoulders if you want to really get into it. And it's a one I saw Paul Gilbert use back in the 80s on a video, not from the 80s. And that's about hitting notes and getting familiar with the fretboard and where these notes are. And he uses E as a great example. There's an E on every single string. So it's the open high E, the fifth fret on the B string, the 9th fret on the G string. On the D string, you're up to the 14th. On the A string, it's the 19th. And obviously an open low E string, or the 24th fret if you've got a 2-octave guitar. And try doing that as fast as you can. So that'll get your memory going and get your fingers accustomed to where you want to go on the fretboard and hit the correct notes. So you're shooting and you're finally scoring by landing on that E note or wherever you end up in whatever solo you're doing. Bit of a daft one, but it's certainly fun to do, and it's a really good feeling when you get it right. Now moving on to the right hand, I have two favourite ones for getting the right hand up to speed. Obviously mix and match this in between your left hand techniques as well, so you're not tiring your left hand out like I have in this video. First thing I do is pick 7 notes, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I was alternate picking them, down pick them. So I'm doing the alternate picking triplet, and the rest are downpicked. Try and get the same triplet technique, but while alternate picking. Kind of mix and match between them, alternate picking the 7 notes and down picking them, triplet picking, alternate picking the triplet bit and down picking the rest and everything in between, but that kind of rhythm, okay? So that's the first thing from my right hand, a bit of a metally kind of thing, I know, but the next one is just weird, funky, and it sounds like Buckethead. If you don't know who Buckethead is, he's amazing. And that is to simply pick all the notes in the string in the air on your guitar and go back one each time. But on your left hand, playing the first note and then using your middle finger, a fret higher and a note higher, and your ring finger, a fret higher and a note higher again. It sounds ridiculous, I know, but it really gets your accuracy up with your right hand. So you're going down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. Now, it's not the most pleasant thing to listen to, but it's funky and it gets your fingers kind of joining together in harmony, if you play it clean, that is. And those, ladies and gentlemen, are my little tips and tricks, daily stretches and warm-ups you should do. You haven't got to do them all, and you haven't got to do them in the order that I showed you. If you don't like some of them, don't do it. If you really enjoy them, do them more. 5 minutes a day. Give your hand a little stretch in the morning when you're getting ready to play guitar, making yourself a nice brew, and just have a little 5 minute play watching the telly. You haven't got to be plugged in. You can do electric guitar or acoustic guitar anywhere on the neck. just have some fun and warm those digits up. I'm so warm right now, I'm gonna wait half an hour, then I'm gonna blow minds and probably record the best solo I've ever recorded in my life. And as always, if you wanna comment anything down below and add anything, please do, because I love learning about this stuff just as much as you guys. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any guitar tips and tricks, get your fine self over to pmtonline.co.uk, look at the blog section, or subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these lovely things, but with nice filters on. I've been Dagan. I'll see you next time.